All right, thank you very much for keeping it live with us. It is the 27th of January 2020. Beautiful Monday morning down here in Kampala. And right about now on the show, we're getting into our love letter this morning. A lady's writing to us saying that his insecurity is affecting our relationship. Details coming through say that, hello, Aben, today. I have been with my boyfriend for a year now. The first few months of our relationship, everything went on well. But later on, he started not allowing me to have my friends over at our house. He says I should tell him whenever and wherever I go. Sometimes he even gets people to follow me around. Last time I failed to pick up his calls. He raised his voice at me. I feel like I am being suffocated. I can barely breathe. He even once beat up a man colleague at work just because he gave me a hug. I have no friends. Lately, no one wants to be with me because of his character. I'm frustrated. I am not sure I love him anymore. I'm thinking of ending this relationship I have with him. Please, I need your advice.
This
is the first thing I said some time back on the show, and you guys all went haywire on me. I told you the biggest threat to a relationship as far as a woman is concerned is insecurity. When it gets to a man, it's pride. You mess with those two things and those two genders, then your relationship is no more. I don't know if you're still going to go haywire on me, but that's it. That's the truth. That's what I was saying in this letter this morning.
Okay. I'm glad this letter came in today, because just over the weekend, me and the girls were having a conversation about something like this.
The girls?
This. Yeah.
Did you just say the girls?
I have friends, you know.
Oh, the girls.
Yeah, the girls, not those girls.
Not those girls.
Not those
girls. So the girls, women, girls.
Yes.
Oh. The baby mama girls.
No, just
you wanted
women.
Which one? Just say it.
Huh? And then we go
and
with that
give
type
you the
of
number,
girls you want.
You are listening.
Okay.
I think it was a girl.
The girls.
This is what I'm going to say. We were having a conversation with the girls, and it so happened we had just watched Obsessed, that Tyler Perry movie. And we were like, let's see what people online have to say about insecurity, jealousy, and how it can ruin a relationship or not. This is what I'm going to say. It's actually a very, very, very big conversation. Like Willis and I always tell people on the show, relationships. Because before you date this man, or before you want to move in with this man or woman, you need to know their streaks. Do they have tempers? Do they have anger issues? Do they have insecurity issues? The telltale signs, which is funny, are always visible. But we take it under the wing of, oh, he's so sweet. And then as the years go on, it progresses. It gets bigger because he understands, or she understands, that you can take it in. Your threshold for discomfort with them is comfortable. So, ladies, and this is most especially to the ladies. I know the men too. Before you decide to be with someone entirely, and also, if you see any red flag, it doesn't mean run per se, address that red flag. There's certain play questions that we ask. I don't know if you guys ask them. I thought I'm the only one who does that stuff. Like when you go out on a date and then you start asking random questions and your date is looking at you like, what the hell? But those questions satisfy particular things. For me, I want to know, do you have an ego problem? Do you have a temper problem? Do you have anger management issues? What is your level of jealousy? Because jealousy is acceptable in what? In any relationship, but you want to see before you can entirely commit. It's so sad that I know what she means. At first, it's endearing. You know, and your man finds you with another guy, and then he goes like, babe, what's that guy? So you'll turn to your friends and you'll make do with yourself too. You'll be like, he just loves me. He doesn't want me to be with anyone else. And it grows. It grows. It grows. If you haven't yet understood what we're talking about, watch that Tyler Perry movie, Obsessed. I was like, okay, that's interesting.
Willis Daly, what do you make of this one? Insecurity is, you know, threatening someone's relationship as we speak.
The thing is this, that as human beings, we are imperfect. I'm not a perfect person. I also have my insecurities. And, you know, when you're in a relationship, you need to know the other person's insecurities.
True.
And know that for me, if I tell my babe that she has a big foot, that's her insecurity. You know, she'll feel bad. I'll have poured water on her fire. You understand? So you need to know your partner's insecurities. I don't want to put it on the guy because it's okay. It's very fine to say, you know, you're insecure. Why is that guy hugging you? Why does he hug you every evening, every time you're leaving work? Bye. So as a guy, he's insecure. He's sort of feeling, you know, that guy is doing my thing.
To the extent of beating up the guy, the co-worker.
Well, that's a different thing. That's anger. That's how to deal with anger. The first, because you can mix the two and forget to solve. You understand? The first thing is insecurity. What are your boyfriend's or your husband's insecurities? Are you taking them into consideration for everything you do? I usually tell people that for everything that you do, for every decision you make, whether you're angry or happy or whatever, you need to think about how it's going to affect the people you love. Not the people that love you, but the people that you love. And say, I love that person. How is this decision going to affect them? So as you're hugging your co-worker, if you know your man's insecurities, you're going to not hug them. You're going to wave at them and say, see you tomorrow.
Okay. Still on him, but I want to ask him a question.
But before you ask him a question, what we're going to do right about now, we'll be getting back to Tina's question. We're going to go in for a very short break. But when we do get back, studio line is going to be open. And we'd like you to call in and let us know what is the best advice you have for this relationship. The number is on your screen and it is 0414-337-872. We'll be picking calls immediately after this break.